Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO DBC Technology. Last year I did my ultimate UniFi apartment setup. This year I'm gonna do it again and I'm gonna do it for $500 less. You may notice that I'm not in my normal setup. Every August we come to Colorado, mainly for IT Nation Evolve, but over the years we've extended that to be 2 weeks, 3 weeks. In the last 2 years, we've spent a whole month here in Colorado. So when I'm gonna spend a month in a vacation home, I basically bring a UniFi apartment setup. This is what I would do if I had an apartment, somewhere where I couldn't drill holes in the wall, I couldn't really modify the building at all, but I still wanted a high-end, high-speed, really robust, complete UniFi network. So let's jump into what I did this year versus what I did last year. Right off the bat, you'll see the major difference between this year and last year is the UCG Fiber. Obviously, it's the belle of the ball this year. Everybody loves this device. It's an amazing device. So last year when we were using the UCG Max, I had to have off-board switching, which we used the Enterprise 8 PoE because it was the only switch at the time that was both 2.5 gigabit Ethernet and PoE plus to power the U7 Pro wall. The cool thing about that is the UCG Fiber has that one port on it that is both 2.5 gigabit and PoE plus to power the U7 Pro wall. Now, this is about an 1,100 square foot apartment. It's not super huge. If I had a bigger apartment, I probably would need to have a PoE injector to do a second lap or get some off-board switching, just letting you know that. But for most apartments, vacation homes, vacation rentals, the U7 Pro wall is gonna be more than enough to give you great coverage. So what are my other updates? Just like last year, I have two cameras here. I kept the G4 Instant, but instead of the G5 Flex, which is an awesome little camera, I did a G6 Instant. It gives me a little bit more flexibility being wireless, that I don't have to have it right by the UCG Fiber, and I get the updated features of it being a G6 camera. And the final difference between this year and last year is I didn't bring the USB strip. First of all, there was only one thing that I was plugging in the quote unquote server closet here, which is the UCG Fiber. Everything is running off of that. And secondly, it really didn't matter to me as much that the internet went down here. I could just reset that modem. You know, I'm obviously sitting here either watching TV or doing something if something happens. So it wasn't as big a deal for me. You know, it's just one less thing I needed to bring out here. It is very nice to have a strip back at home though, because if the internet goes down there, obviously it's nice to have it recycle the modem there and keep the network up and running. So if I was doing this as an apartment setup, I would add that USB strip back into the equation there. And here's a couple other optional things that I think could work. Last year, I mentioned the PoE plus adapter. That would still be a nice thing to have here. Obviously, I only have that one port on the UCG Fiber. So if I wanted multiple PoE plus things, I could get another adapter there. And those are only 15 bucks. I tried to minimize the amount of cables and stuff that I was bringing. So I didn't add that this year. Also, last year, I talked about the Flex 10 GBE. I think that's an incredible little switch. I used that for years, like I mentioned in the video last year. So if you were in an apartment and wanted some extra 10 gigabit connectivity, I think that's a great value at $299. And finally, if you did want switching like I had last year with that Enterprise 8 PoE, I think the new Pro XG 8 PoE is a really incredible switch at $499. Obviously, that's a little expensive for this setup, but if you wanted the ultimate UniFi apartment setup, I think that's an incredible value there. You get PoE++ and 10 gigabit on everything. So you just basically can plug anything in and go. So you can see this year is considerably less expensive than last year. And I feel like this year has actually got a little bit more capability. I went with a 1 terabyte UCG Fiber. Last year I went with 512 and the UCG Max. You could do that and save some money by buying UCG Fiber, buying a tray. And if you have an extra M.2 drive lying around, even save more money. But you know, whatever size M.2 drive you wanna do, you could do that yourself and kind of save a little bit more money there as well. But let's jump into the software real quick. I want to show you how I'm using it here in Beaver Creek and how I'm connecting back to my home. I want to show you how I'm using my Plex and the other services that are hosted at my house. So let's dive in. So you can see I've got everything running here in my UCG Fiber. First thing you have to consider is that some of the infrastructure in a vacation rental or an apartment may be kind of suboptimal. So we're in a different place than we were last year. Last year, the modem was just out in the living room. This year, the cable modem was in the guest bedroom closet. It was actually a much nicer setup. It had a really nice access panel and everything was nicely done inside of the unit. But as I was mentioning, every place is going to be a little different. So the Comcast cable modem this year and last year were identical setups. I was able to plug into port one. It just did a pass through. This year, and because I'm a little bit of a nerd, I was able to log into the cable modem. They hadn't changed their default username and password, and I put it in bridge mode. I didn't really need to do that, and we'll cover it a little bit more when I go over the VPN here. But from there on our setup, I just plugged this U7 Pro wall into the PoE Plus 2.5 gigabit port. You can see it's running there at 2.5 gigahertz. It's really super easy. So I've got the G4 Instant and the G6 Instant connected wirelessly. Very simple and easy to set those up. I've got videos on each of those if you're interested in how those get set up, but really simple. On both of them, I needed to reset them because they had been connected to a previous network, but just push the reset button and they actually talk to you and walk through resetting them and getting them reacquired. Super easy. Apology here is very, very simple. I've got the Mac that I'm recording on right now, the G6 Instant, R2 cell phones, that's my wife and my cell phone, the G4 Instance, and the main TV in the living room here. And if I wanted to add one of those optional switches there, I could add that there and let that go. So very, very simple setup here. Very fast. Everything's just jamming. Really well done. Super happy with the set. Super happy with the ease of the setup. Like I said, I did put that in bridge mode, but I didn't need to set that in bridge mode. I'll show you here how I set up the VPN and how super easy that is. I'm going to go back into Site Manager. This is all our different devices here. And there's a SiteMagic SD-WAN icon over here. And it is very, very simple to set this up. All I had to do, and I'll go ahead and say click plus to create a new one there, is you just select which network. This is a mesh network. I've got a video where I go more deep into SD-WAN, but for this instance where I'm just connecting one to another, it's just a mesh, and I get started, and it just will ask you which site. Obviously, I don't have anything available right now, but what I did was I clicked Beaver Creek, and I clicked the UCG Fiber, which is my home network. Now, I have a WAN IP on the Beaver Creek Cloud Gateway, which I have because I put it in bridge mode. I did not need to do that. I could have left this as a pass-through and gotten that 10.0.0.x IP address that the Comcast cable modem would have given me. All you have to do to set up this SD-WAN, though, is have one of the two gateways have that external WAN IP address. So anyways, these both do, but I did not need that. And then all you do is click add, and you, boom. It will then give you an option there if you have multiple networks set up, which two networks that you want to connect. On my home network, I've got multiple networks. So I've got an IoT, I've got a guest network, and et cetera, et cetera. So you just pick the two that you want to connect. I will also tell you that you cannot have conflicting IP addresses. So these are 192.168.2.0, and these are 192.168.1.0. That goes for all of the other networks as well. So I couldn't have a 192.168.2 network on the UCG Fiber. It would conflict with this and it wouldn't connect correctly. So that's all it is. It's really one button click, and then all of a sudden you can ping from network to network, and each network acts as if each network is on the same site. What's really cool, and I didn't do it here, is both my UCG Fiber at home and my UCG Fiber here at Beaver Creek have Protect on them. So I've got a camera back at home. I left a camera on there. I don't normally have a camera in my house, but I left a camera on just so I could see if anybody was coming and going while we were gone. And here I have two cameras going because I wanted to be able to see, we brought our dog Sketch with us. And when we're out and about, I wanted to make sure that Sketch was okay. So you can see this is me recording right now, and I put the other one outside here. A little smoky today. I think there's some fires off in the distance. You can see Sketch walking around doing his thing. So anyways, really cool for us here, you know, and if you had an apartment, to have a couple cameras, the UCG Fiber with a 1 terabyte card in it is really pretty capable in VR. So, you know, if you want to have multiple cameras, you can easily do that. Also with the UCG Fiber and the UCG Max, you can do all of the different UniFi things. So if you want to do talk or access or those other things, you could do it. Probably not so applicable to an apartment setup, but you have them if you want to do all of the different features as well. But one cool thing about being on the VPN is I could have, if I wanted to, you can see here on the UCG Fiber, if I go back into devices here, this is back at my house where I used to have the G4 Instant and the G6 Instance. You can see it sees them here in Colorado. This device is in Florida, but it sees them across this VPN in Colorado. So if I wanted to, what I could do is I could put all of those devices on the NVR here in Colorado or the NVR there in Jacksonville and be able to see all three of those feeds in the same instance. I could also do that with Vantage Point, a bunch of different ways you could do that. But if you are going to ever join a camera across a VPN to another network, I would make sure that that camera has edge recording, because if your VPN ever goes down, you'll lose recording. But you could also do this in Vantage Point. But anyways, a lot of flexibility and coolness you can do with that across the VPN. Also, you may have noticed behind me that my TV is running Plex right now. I have a Plex server home, and I am actually hitting that across the VPN. Now, I use Cloudflare and can do a reverse proxy to hit the Plex server and not open up any ports on the UCG Fiber at home. But sometimes that's a little bit difficult to do with the apps that are built into TVs, because they don't prompt you for the authentication for that Cloudflare tunnel. So running across the VPN makes it super easy. There are a couple settings in the Plex app that you do want to make sure that you have set correctly to run it across the VPN. First of all, you want to go down in the settings and choose a manual server and direct it to the IP address of your Plex server. And second of all, you want to change some of the security settings to allow what it's calling unsecured connections, which is just basically letting you connect it back to that server across this VPN. But that's really awesome for us. My wife mainly watches TV on the Plex, so it's cool to be able to bring that along. Also, I have the HL15 back at home. It's on the .1 network, and obviously I'm on .2 network here. I'm able just to ping it and go right into it and do everything that I normally do on my TrueNAS, and I'm able to get to all my files on my UNAS Pro back at home just as if it is here. So that's a really awesome feature for anybody that has a vacation home or vacation rental to be able to access all of your normal stuff without having to jump through any hoops. It's really cool. It's really convenient. It makes coming out here for a month really easy on me. I don't have to worry, do I have access to that footage or a file or an image? It's all here. It's all available for me. And all the services that I use at home, my home assistant, all that stuff, I can just ping it really quickly and be right in it, no problem. And with an app like Home Assistant, I'm able to control everything back at home. This is my home back in Jacksonville. I can turn on and off lights, turn down the thermostat, check everything, basically have total control of my home over the network without having to open up any ports and do anything. It's really pretty amazing. So that pretty much sums up what I've been doing over the past couple of years with my Ultimate UniFi apartment setup. I'd love to hear what you guys are doing with your Ultimate UniFi apartment setup, what you would add, what you would subtract, what you would replace in my setup. Please put all that down in the comments down below. I'd love to have that conversation. As always, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.